Hey friends, this is Dan at Manychat. I'm here to introduce you to this focaccia bread, which looks delicious. You know what else is delicious? Getting Messenger subscribers. And as it turns out, we have a tool that makes this really easy. We have all these overlays and this bar overlay and a couple of other growth tools which are really powerful. And if you don't have these installed yet, this is the video for you. So I've set up a bar overlay already here just to test on my own site. And this is, again, you just click on growth tools on the left side of your dashboard here, and it will expose all of these different types of growth tools. To create a new one, it's really simple. You just click new growth tool, and here are all the different types. Right now, don't worry about all these different types. Just we're going to focus on this one test that I have set up for you. The point of this video is to get you comfortable with setting up growth tools on your website. My only goal is to get you to get these on your website. The reason why this is important is because our growth tools magically convert traffic into subscribers, and that's what these things are for. So whether you have a website that gets traffic, or you have a Facebook page that gets traffic, or you have Facebook ads where you can buy traffic, these widgets, these growth tools are going to help you grow your subscriber base. And this is actually one of the most important parts of Messenger marketing, is having people to market to. So let's go check out this one growth tool that I have set up already. Check this out. It's a bar overlay, and I'm sure you've seen this around the internet before. It pops over at the top of your website, and I've already set this up for my own use case. So I have expertise in B2B software as a service, and one of the biggest things that plagues software as a service companies is churn. So I have this offer at the top of my website that says, "Hey, do you have some questions about how to cut your churn in half?" And what I give my subscribers an option to do, or people who hit my website, is send me a question. And I'm going to show you how to set this up on your website. So this is the initial state. This is where you set up all of your basic parameters. So when should this display? Well, I have it set to display or to pop up as soon as 30% of the web page has been scrolled. Also, I show this to the same user over and over again, but you can show it to them only once. You can show it to them and delay it so that it shows only after 3 more hours have passed. In other words, we give you a ton of flexibility about how to show this to people. Also, if somebody manually closes it, the next time that they load the page, when's the next time that you want them to see this? Really useful, really flexible tools here. So to edit this is really simple. To edit the headline, you just click into the box here. It's a visual editor. And then if you want to edit the call to action button, you have to make sure you're using the checkbox plugin. So it's the button type with checkbox. If you just use the send to messenger plugin, this is what it looks like. And that's pretty cool too, but I like being able to adjust the copy on this button. And this actually bypasses, if somebody clicks on this on your website, this actually bypasses the welcome message and goes straight to the campaign that you want to send them to. So that's another hack here, is using the bar overlay with the checkbox plugin sends them right to the campaign. So let's go to the submitted state. So after they click the button, this is somebody who is in your traffic, somebody who's hitting your website, for example. As soon as they click that button, this is what they're going to see. And again, you can customize this too. For this case, because I'm asking them to send me a question, the next step that I want them to take is to open Messenger. And again, I've tailored this button copy, which I just click right in here to edit, to tell them to open Messenger. If they click this button, this will actually open messenger.com in their browser. And again, you can also put in a redirect if you wanted to, so that when somebody clicks that initial button, that call to action, it can redirect to any URL. So if you want to track conversions using your own tools, that's another way to do it. We just covered the submitted state, which is great, and then the opt-in actions. So this is one of the most critical parts of setting up your growth tool, which is what is going to happen when somebody clicks that button, that call to action button. Well, you want to start a Messenger conversation with them. So this is where you set that up. So I've already set up a message here, and you can just click edit right there. I'm not going to edit it right now because I don't want to lose any changes, but this is what it's going to look like when somebody hits that button. All right, I have a couple of these quick replies set up with some actions on those quick replies, and I'm going to show you live how this is supposed to work. Also, if you want to, this is one of the most powerful parts of any of these overlays, is that you can subscribe people to sequences as soon as they hit this growth tool. So this is what it would look like for your user or for your subscriber. I'm just a person. I hit Dan's website. I see this bar overlay at the top of his website with an offer that makes sense to me. I click the messenger button. In one action, I'm taken now into a messenger conversation. And, you know, if I interact with that messenger conversation at all, I become a subscriber in ManyChat and I get subscribed to this sequence. So anybody who's been using Infusionsoft or any of these kind of marketing automation platforms, you already see how powerful this can be. So I'm not going to harp on it too much. Let's go to this setup. And this is without this part, things just aren't going to work. The next thing you want to do after you've set up the opt-in actions and the submitted state and the initial state is head over to this setup screen, and you want to install the JavaScript snippet. And if there's one place where I think people get hung up, it's this. This is not a difficult part of the task. If you have a web designer, they will know exactly what to do right away. So all you have to do is give them this JavaScript snippet, and they'll know exactly what to do with it. So excuse me. Install JavaScript snippet. Click on that. And this is what you want to do. You want to whitelist any domain that this is going on. So for this case, it's going to be stealthpdx.com add. And I'm also going to add HTTP stealthpdx.com and one more thing, HTTPS stealthpdx.com. Now, the reason why I'm using the secure HTTP as well is because I'm going to show you how to install this JavaScript snippet on Squarespace as well. Now, Squarespace, I think last time I checked, comes with an SSL certificate on every domain. So what you can do is, what's going to end up happening is you're going to have a secure connection, and if you don't specify this HTTPS right here in the whitelisting process, it won't show up on your site. That's just a little hack that I wanted to show people. Install the JavaScript snippet. This is where the magic is happening. So copy code to clipboard. And this is where things get a little tricky. Again, if you have a web designer, don't even watch the next part of this video. Just send your web designer this script and say, hey, I need this installed. They're going to know where to install it. But for all of you who want to attempt to do this on your own, this is how you do it. I'm going to FTP into my WordPress build right now. I have a live site. I use Transmit. I'm on a Mac, and I love this, the company that makes this piece of software. Where you're going to want to put this is in your header.php. So I've already found it. If you're using WordPress, you FTP into your public HTML. You want to grab the domain name that you set up. You want to go to WP Content, Themes, the theme that you're using, and then you want to grab the header.php file. So that's because you're trying to insert this code into the head. So let's go ahead and open with Atom. This is the text editor that I like to use. Again, I just copied and pasted that code that we got from ManyChat, this right here, copied. And I'm going to just install it right here. So see this closing head tag? I'm just going to put a return there, and I'm going to paste in the ManyChat code, just like that. So as you see, the script is right here, and it's right before the closing head tag. I'm going to click Save on that. I'm going to Command S on a Mac. I'm going to go back, and it looks like Transmit has accepted that that change. I'm going to go over here and head over to my WordPress install and just double check inside the theme that this has been changed. So I've got the theme header.php open inside of WordPress, and there it is. There's the script. So as of now, I have the ManyChat script installed in my head. And that's all that you need. That's all that you need to get going with growth tools. It's actually that simple. The next part is going to be actually testing it. So let's head back here and let's save this. And I think this is all set up. I don't think that there's any reason why this shouldn't work right now. Let's just go to active. Let's activate this growth tool. And as of right now, this should show up on every single page of my website because I haven't chosen to show it on only certain pages or exclude it on certain pages. Keep in mind that you can also hide these on mobile devices. When it comes to the bar overlay, this thing is amazing. This shows up really well on all devices. This is one of the most robust growth tools that we have simply because it spans across all the different devices and it works really, really well. So let's go head over to my website and I want to show you and see this thing work in real life. Even better, when you're doing testing, this is a really like little hack that we discovered. When you're testing your growth tools, test them inside of an incognito window in Chrome, because you're going to be able to refresh that page over and over again, and hopefully the growth tool will continue to show up because of the way that our cookies work. So let's go over here. Let's refresh the page. And all right, let's go ahead and scroll about 30% or so and see if that overlay pops up. And there it is. Look at that beautiful overlay. It's just, it looks so nice, and it's pretty responsive too. Let's go ahead and click the CTA here. Send me a question, because I definitely want to send Dan a question. Did you see that? Just popped up in Messenger. And let's just open it using the link just to show you how that works. All right, this is awesome. Let's take a look at this. So this is the message that we programmed into the bot to send when somebody clicks on that call to action. You have these two awesome quick reply buttons. And what I did is I actually set this up so that if I click on either of these, it will tag me with a tag that I'm using for marketing segmentation. We'll get into marketing segmentation a little bit later. But if you're already doing email marketing and marketing automation, you know what I'm talking about. So in this case, I'm going to go ahead and say I work at a SaaS. Okay, so, and then you could start a conversation from here. This is how cool it is. It's almost like having live chat in Messenger on your web page without having it like directly on the page. I mean, this is as close as you're going to get to Messenger live chat until they come out with that feature. So right now, we've just demonstrated the use of the bar overlay, and I've also just showed you how to get this installed on a WordPress website. And for all you Squarespace users out there, I know a lot of people are moving from WordPress to Squarespace. I'm going to show you quickly how to set up that JavaScript snippet in Squarespace, and that will be it for this one, I think. So just give me a second to get that set up. All right, I just opened my Squarespace dashboard in another window, and I'm back here in the ManyChat dashboard to grab this install JavaScript snippet thingy. This is the code that we want to copy into Squarespace, and this is how we do it real quick. Go to your dashboard, go here to settings, go here to advanced, and then I think it's code injection, and you just drop it right here in the header. So this is awesome how easy this is. You just press save, and as long as your domain is whitelisted in ManyChat using that process earlier in this video, you will be able to use all of your ManyChat growth tools on Squarespace as well. Now, look at this form that we just, like this pattern that we just did. If you have an advanced theme in WordPress, or you have another, you know, another kind of platform that you're using for your website, look for something that looks like this. You're going to look for any kind of advanced settings, or you know, anywhere where you're going to be able to edit the code of your website. Go to advanced, look for something like code injection or header or, you know, theme files. Go to that place, and it's probably going to have something like this in there somewhere where you can edit the header or drop code into the header. And that's where you want to put ManyChat code so that you can use those growth tools on your website. All right, hopefully this has been kind of useful for you guys getting started with growth tools. I can't wait to show you the rest of these growth tools, because the bar overlay widget is just one of many. And once again, growth tools are designed to turn traffic into subscribers, and subscribers in Messenger are very valuable if you run a business. Okay, look forward to showing you those.